Hey everyone, this is Kyle with The Technical Accountant. Today we're going to cover four perfect scenarios of when you want to use a VLOOKUP formula in accounting. As always, this spreadsheet that we're going to walk through today will be available for download in the link below. It'll have all the formulas and all the examples so that you can use it after the fact if you like to kind of refresh yourself on what you've seen today. Let's hop right in. So in this sheet here, I've got a couple different tabs at the bottom. Vendors, addresses, payables, activity, items, GL accounts, journal entries. We'll use all these tabs as we build these formulas. The first example we're going to go into is just a basic VLOOKUP. The idea with a VLOOKUP is it's actually called a vertical lookup, but you can go and find something on one sheet and pull information from another sheet. So example being, I've got my payables transactions listing here. See, I got the vendor ID, I got the document number, document type, how much the payable was. I don't have the vendor name. So, you know, the vendor ID is not very helpful for me. So I'm actually going to use a VLOOKUP here. So VLOOKUP, and I tap through and you'll see it's saying lookup value. Well, that's saying, what do you want to go find and go find its match somewhere else? So I want to go find this vendor ID, Trey Reese. Then you see here, it says comma, table array. Table array means where do you want to go find Trey Reese here? Well, I want to go over to my vendors tab. Let's click the vendors. You'll see the formula here kind of updates to the vendors. And I want to go find it in the first column here. The way VLOOKUP works, very important to know, is it'll always go find what's in the leftmost column of what you select. That'll make sense here in a second. So my table array, so again, I want to go find that vendor ID in the vendor ID column on the vendors tab. And then I'm about to pull the vendor name. So I'm actually going to highlight over to B and you'll see that becomes my table array. Columns A and column B, that's my table array. You see here, and now once a comma. Now the column index number means of your table array that you just selected, A and B, which column do you want to return? Column one or column two? Column two here is what I want to pull back. I'm going to pull back the vendor name. So if I had selected all the way out to column F, I think F would have been six, but again, I'm just selecting column two for the vendor name. Now I want a comma. Now the range lookup, do you want an exact match or do you want something approximate? In this situation, I want that exact match. I want to make sure the vendor ID matches, so I'm pulling back the correct vendor name. So I'm actually just going to go down to false here, tab out, close it, hit enter. And there it is. So Trey Reese, if I go back over to the vendors, go down to Trey Reese. There's Trey Research. And you see, we just pulled it in. So now I can drop this down. And I have my full listing of vendor names on my payables transaction sheet here. Second example, we're going to use the inventory transaction listing. And we're going to pull the current cost from the item listing. So that might be useful if you want to go and see, let's look at all of our sales over the past month. Let's see what the current cost would be if we were to buy these items today to see if we made or lost any money, I guess if that makes sense. So in this situation, again, just a very basic VLOOKUP formula. Let's go equals VLOOKUP. Well, what's my match? My match here is obviously going to be the item number. Because if I look back over here, here's my item number. And then I see there's a current cost column. So let's go find this value, phone ATT0712. Let's hit a comma because that's what it's asking for. Now it says, what's the table array? Where do you want to go find this item number? So again, I'm going to go over to the item master here. And the item number is in my leftmost column. VLOOKUP, it always has to be in your leftmost column. So let's highlight from A all the way over to F. And you see here that it says six, 6C, that means current cost is the sixth column that you're selecting. Useful for the next step here. So now once a comma, now again, column index number, we will return F. It just told us that was number six. I could also go A, B, C, D, E, F, but again, it told us a second ago. So column six. And again, I'm looking for that exact match. I can't think of too many examples where you'd want to use a approximate match. I'm sure they exist, but I think in the accounting world, you want that exact match. So let's tab down here with the false. Want that exact match. Hit enter. And there we go. I've got my current cost. And I can drop this all the way down. So now with this information, I could get crafty and say, okay, well, unit cost here. So if we were to buy this item today, it would have costed us another $1.30. Pretty basic example here. Now let's go to the third example. We can use VLOOKUPs to see if there is activity, if there is a match across two different sheets. Example being, I've got my list of GL accounts all here on the left-hand side. I'm curious to know if these accounts are even in use, if they've ever been used, because I might consider getting rid of some of these accounts, cleaning up my account listing. So let's do this. So let's do equals VLOOKUP. Again, I'm going to go find just this particular value. Let's go to my journal entry listing. You'll see here again, the leftmost column, again, very important. In this situation, my array, I only care about one single column. I just want to see if the account number exists at all in this JE's tab. So I'm just selecting column A. Now once a comma, column index number one, I've only selected one column, comma, and again, I want that exact match. Going down to false, tabbing, closing, and there we go. So what it's saying is that it went and it found this account over my JE's activity. So you see, if I drop this down, this is where it's become useful. Look at all these NAs. What this is telling me is that this account number right here does not exist at all over my journal entries tab. So if it doesn't exist, it may not be needed, I can delete it. So we can also clean this up a little bit. Instead of it kind of airing out and saying NA, you can use an additional formula if you want to get clean with it. We'll say if error. We've got our VLOOKUP formula. I'm going to go to the end, comma, and the value if it's an error. Let's say account never used. Let's close it, and you'll see what this looks like here. Drop it all the way down. Now it's spelling it out for me. Account has never been used. Now let's go into our fourth example. This one's a little more sophisticated. You'll see why. But what we're going to do is I got my payables listed again. I'm going to find the address one, particularly for the payments. I want to find out what the address was that I sent the payments to. And how this is going to work is it's going to be a little tricky. And you'll see why. Because a vendor can have multiple addresses. So if I go to the vendor addresses tab, I see Ace Travel in here multiple times. There's a primary, there's a remit to. So my perfect match between the two is going to be a combination of the vendor ID and the address code. So what I have to do here is I have to create a concatenated column that combines the two. This is good and bad of VLOOKUP. There's easier ways to do this. We'll get to it to the end, but with VLOOKUP, I can only look up a single column, a single field, and return the results. So I have to concatenate the two. So that's what I've done here. So you see Ace Travel Primary, Ace Travel Remit 2. And then back on my payables, I need to basically do the same thing in order to get this match. I need to get that one-to-one match. So let's go concatenate. And I want to concatenate the vendor ID. And I want to concatenate the address code. So this field is actually what I'm going to be matching on. Let's just go ahead and drag that all the way down. All right, and now I'm ready to create my VLOOKUP formula. So VLOOKUP, what am I going to go look for? What is the match that I have to go and find? Well, it's going to be the concatenation between the vendor ID and the address code. So I'm selecting H2 here. It wants the comma, table array. Again, where do I want to go find this combination at? Obviously over in addresses. So here it is in column C. So I'm selecting C and I want to return address one. So I drag over to column D. Again, I see that number two, the second column is what I'm going to be returning. So now once it's comma, column index number, again, number two, comma, go down to false, tab, get the exact match. So there we go. So once I drop this down, so let's go find Trey Reese again, and let's go find the primary address code. And here's Trey Reese, here's primary. You see P.O. Box 5678. P.O. Box 5678. Now let's talk about a couple of the examples where VLOOKUP is a little tricky, maybe not the best tool for the job. Example one being, it can only go left or right. So again, we saw this multiple times here. I always had to select the leftmost column. That's where I want to find my match. I drag my table array to the right and then return column 2, 4, 6, whatever. Kind of a downfall, because again, if vendor ID here was on the furthest right, I would have had to move it or whatever. Just, you know, a little dicey. Just know it always goes left to right. The other downfall is kind of with a VLOOKUP, you can only return a single field. So I only pulled in address one here. If I wanted to pull address one and address two, I would have had to create a separate column here called address two. And I would have had to basically do the same formula again, this time pulling address two. The other thing is we saw earlier when we were looking for a match on the GL accounts, you know, we had to get a little crafty. We had to put in the if error, then say account never used. Not the most difficult thing in the world, but again, it's just extra steps, extra things to remember. And sometimes you forget it, then all of a sudden you got the NA errors over the place. So, you know, kind of a downfall of VLOOKUP. And really the last downfall kind of a VLOOKUP was when we wanted to concatenate two fields. If I had to go and find, you know, the combination of the vendor ID and the address code, I had to basically build that concatenated formula first and then go look up apples to apples. You know, not ideal. Basically, all these downfalls of VLOOKUP, they are doable kind of out of the box with an XLOOKUP formula. So VLOOKUP, fantastic. You know, very easy to use once you kind of use it a couple times. If you want to kind of take the next step, really take a look at XLOOKUP. I did post another video on XLOOKUPs, kind of going through how you use a formula, and you can say, you know, if there's not a result, then, you know, tell us account does not exist. That kind of stuff is built. It makes it a little bit easier for your run-of-the-mill situation where, look, I know that I got vendor ID in two different sheets. I just need to return the vendor name. XLOOKUP is hands down the way to go. Easy as can be. So again, I'm Kyle with The Technical Accountant. I hope you enjoyed this. I hope this helps. Definitely check out the downloadable spreadsheet in the links below. And if you have any questions, post them in the comments below. I'm here to help out and respond to you as soon as humanly possible, as soon as I see it. That's my sole purpose, is just to share some information with everyone. Again, Kyle with The Technical Accountant. See you next time.